Welcome to the Blazor Data Grid tutorial. Here, I will show you how to freeze rows and columns in the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component. Frozen columns and rows in a grid remain locked in place, staying visible while users scroll through the rest of the data. This feature is a boon for big datasets, ensuring key information stays in view for easy reading and analysis. First, let me open an existing Blazor WebAssembly app, where I added the Syncfusion Blazor Data Grid component with the data source property bound to the orders list. If you want to learn how to get started with the Blazor Data Grid component, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. You can also find this example by following the link provided in the description below. Let's run the example application. As you can see, the Blazor Data Grid component is rendered with the orders data source. In this video, I'll explore different ways to implement frozen columns and rows in the Blazor Data Grid component. This will enhance your experience when working with large datasets, making it easier and more efficient. You will learn how to incorporate frozen rows and columns, freeze specific columns, adjust direction, and enable frozen columns through dragging the column separator. Now, I will show you how to implement frozen columns in the Blazor Data Grid component. Before implementation, I need to add more columns to our data grid. I can do this by adding additional properties to our order class and updating the values for these properties in our data list. With the additional columns added, I can now update the grid column tag to display the newly created properties. To enable frozen columns in Blazor Data Grid, I need to define the frozen columns property to 3, which allows you to specify the number of columns to be frozen. In this case, the first 3 columns of the data grid will be frozen. I also need to set the height and width of the content area using the height and width property. Look now, when I scroll horizontally, you can see the first 3 columns remain frozen. Next, I will show you how to implement frozen rows. To implement this feature, I can utilize the frozen rows property to 3. This configuration allows for specifying the number of rows to be frozen, and as a result, the first 3 rows of the data grid will be frozen. Look now, when I scroll vertically, you can see the first 3 records are frozen. Next, I will demonstrate how to implement a freeze particular column in the data grid. To enable the freeze particular column, first I remove the frozen rows and frozen columns property for clear understanding purposes. Then I add the particular column to freeze. In this case, I set the isFrozen property to true in order ID and ship country columns. Look now, when I scroll horizontally, you can see both the order ID and ship country column remains frozen, while the other columns are movable. Next, I will show you how to implement a freeze direction in the Blazor data grid. It allows you to freeze columns on the left, right, or fixed positions of the grid while the remaining columns are movable. This feature is implemented using the freeze and isFrozen properties. To enable the freeze direction, I set the freeze property to freeze direction right for the order ID column. Then, I set the isFrozen property to true and freeze direction fixed for the order date column. Additionally, I set the freeze direction left for the ship country column. Look now, the order ID column is frozen on the right side of the grid, and ship country is frozen on the left side. When I scroll horizontally, the order date is fixed while other columns are movable. Next, let's look at how to implement frozen columns by dragging the column separator in the Blazor data grid. To freeze or unfreeze columns in the Blazor data grid, drag the column separator left or right. This separator is the vertical line between columns. A frozen column stays on the left side, never scrolling out of view. To enable this feature, I need to set the allow freeze line moving property to true. This property controls whether users can move the freeze line to the left or right to freeze or unfreeze columns. Look now, and see the ship country and order ID column is frozen, while other columns are movable. Now listen, when I simply drag the vertical line from the ship country column to drop it on the customer name column. Now I scroll horizontally, you'll see that the customer name column is also frozen. Now let me summarize the key takeaways from this video. First, I covered how to freeze rows and columns in a grid. Also, I explained how to freeze specific columns and directions and demonstrated how to freeze columns by dragging the column separator. For more information on the grid features, be sure to check out the documentation link provided in the video description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel for future content. Thank you.